Jack Nolan at the Goog with the leading receiver on this year's Notre Dame team with 14 catches, including a big touchdown catch against Michigan, Chris Fink. How's that sound to you? You were a preferred walk-on, still a walk-on, earned a scholarship after a year, and now you're a go-to guy.
I actually didn't know that I was the leading receiver until you just said that. I don't really look at the stats like that, but obviously you said it's nice to understand how far I've come from where I got here, but there's so much more that I can accomplish and that this receiver group can accomplish, and we're all just trying to really step on the gas and be better as a group.
How do you think that you have improved since you got on campus?
I think I've improved in a lot of ways, and that's just what happens when you're around great coaching and a great locker room. This is going into my fourth year, so just the football IQ and being smart out there and being able to play fast and have confidence, I think, are some big things for me.
You were a great punt returner in high school to the point where that's where you got your nickname, the Slippery Fox. But when Coach Kelly and I talked to them about this after the Wake Forest game, sent you out last year, your chief job was to be a safe guy, make sure you caught the ball. And if there was something there, go ahead. But against Wake Forest, 52-yard return that set up the third touchdown of the game, do you feel – I know in your head you always thought you were a threat, but do you feel you've now transitioned where you are somebody that they have to worry about every time they kick the ball to you?
Like you said, I've always felt that way. Even last year, you said that maybe my job was to be a safe guy, but my thought process was always I'm going to go out there and make a play, which probably led me to take a few chances that I probably shouldn't have last year, and I think I've gotten a little better with that this year and acknowledging, having that internal clock in my head, just knowing when I'm going to have a chance or not. But like you said, it's nice to finally do it, and got really close, so trying to get the extra couple yards next time, and I just had really good blocking, and everybody did their job on that play, so it's nice when it all comes together.
Takes a lot of toughness too, because especially a lot of times last year, I knew you wanted to make that play to the point where maybe there were some balls you should have fair caught that you didn't, and you paid a little bit of a price for it, but you didn't cough it up.
No, I mean, I don't mind the physical toll. I don't mind getting hit. It's just part of the game. So, like you said, I probably took a couple chances that I shouldn't have, but this year just trying to be a little smarter, and I have a little bit bigger role offensively, so just keeping that in mind while I'm back there as well.
Huge game this weekend. I was surprised to learn that in the storied history of Notre Dame Stadium, this is only the 35th time, all time, that two top 10 teams have met in the stadium. So you know the whole country is going to be watching this weekend.
Yeah, it's gonna be a fun one, hopefully, and we know that it's a big matchup, and we're not looking too far ahead and trying to build up the hype for it. We're just taking it one day at a time at practice, you know, focus on having a good Wednesday practice today, focus on having a good Thursday practice tomorrow, and putting in the extra work in terms of watching film.
You haven't had the Legends Trophy that goes to the winner of this game each year in this building since 2014. And when I've heard Coach mention that the last week or so, you guys obviously really, really want it. Where does this rivalry with Stanford sit with all the many rivalries Notre Dame's involved with?
It's a great rivalry. We play them every year. And like you said, in my entire time that I've been here, haven't had a chance to beat them. So really itching to get out there and hopefully do it this year.
As you look at their defense, that has been very stingy in terms of giving up points and is one of the better defenses on your schedule this year. What do you see as the biggest challenges in putting points on Stanford?
I think we just have to be very disciplined going against Stanford. They're a very disciplined team, and they're a smart team, and they play hard. That's kind of just the standard that comes with being at a school like Stanford or Notre Dame. So we know that we're going to have to prepare extra hard to be able to match that and outdo it, hopefully.
Chris, thank you for the time. Good luck this weekend.
Thank you, Jack.
With Chris Fink, I'm Jack Nolan, Fighting Irish Media.